Most people, when they think, oh, I got to put a garden, they think of years past of when they were a child and their parents had a massive garden. They were always out there working, and it just seemed like a very tedious job. But they didn't realize as that young age the reward that they got and the financial benefits that it reaped, that you didn't have to go buy 10 pounds of tomatoes a year, or you didn't have to go buy, you know, corn or green beans. You could preserve that. The average meal that a person will eat is about 1,500 miles from field to plate. If you can grow at least something and cut that down to maybe 500 feet, or just walk out the back door or reach in the window of the kitchen, greatly reduces the, you know, the fossil fuels that are burnt. It saves you money. It actually helps you, your health, because as soon as a fruit or vegetable is picked, it starts to rot. The sugars start to break down, and as that travels across the country in a truck or a train, you're losing a lot of nutrients in that fruit.
And I think just for families in general, whether you're a family of 2 or 10, if you are working in that garden together and you're working towards, you know, being self-sufficient, you're going to be a lot closer than the family that's out, you know. Not anything against the family that does this, but if you're one kid's at the mall, one kid's at soccer, one kid's at a friend's house, if you're working together towards a common goal, even if it's just a couple hours a week, you're going to be more close-knit, and you're going to have, I think, just happier family time altogether.
So the main thing is start small. Don't go in the backyard and go, okay, I've got 2,500 feet, I'm flipping it all over and I'm going to plant, because it's going to get overwhelming. You want to start small. We started at 900 square feet, and to some people that may be very excessive, but, you know, I grew up in an agricultural background where I knew that I could manage that kind of size. Then we went to 1,100, then we went to 1,900, and now we're at like 2,500 square feet in the three different locations that we garden, plus the containers.
Mm-hmm.
So start small, understand what you're growing, and, you know, don't try to grow too many different things. Start off with green beans and tomatoes. Understand how those plants grow. Understand the what you need to do to make those plants produce
correctly.
And then work your way, you know, into more vegetables and fruits in your garden.
Right.
And mostly for everything you see in the garden, except for some of the fencing, it was free. All 85 tomato cages, 86 tomato cages we got was completely free. People would throw them out at the end of the year because they don't want a storm.
Or they might have a leg busted on them or something.
And I've seen them where the tomato was actually inside the cage and they just threw the whole thing to the curb to where they just didn't want to mess with it. Just simply on junk day, walk down the street. Just walk down your block. You don't have to get in a car and drive. Just see what other people are throwing out and how you can incorporate that into your garden. Even like you know, a tomato cage inside of a container, you can bring that in. You can put a couple of green beans in it. You can put some bush beans in it, set it on your porch or patio. And you know, use it that way, or even grow herbs in the window with it.
Or even maybe you don't necessarily want to pick up your neighbor's trash, or what you think is trash. Think about something before you throw it away. Can you reuse it for a different purpose?
As long as the internet is available, the knowledge is out there. You've just got to check your facts. Is it obviously anybody can put anything on the internet, but the viable resources are out there to have the knowledge to and there's books out there too that are good too, to understand how to grow things. And to, you know, be more resourceful as our generations have in the past have before they had anything.
I think a lot of people are now moving to becoming more self-sufficient. People are seeing what's going on within the government. They're seeing what's going on within their own workplace. They're seeing layoffs. They're seeing their friends getting laid off. They're seeing, you know, an absence of jobs. So I think they're starting to realize that they're going to have to make a difference somehow, whether that be storing food, growing their own food, or buying at a discounted price.
Taking control and not relying on somebody else to provide something that they need.
It's definitely benefited our health. It's something that, you know, eating the fresh whole food has been good for our health, that's for sure. As a couple, I think that it's something that we do together that helps create a bond for us. When we moved to Milwaukee, or for me, back to the area, and Joey fresh to the area, it was an adjustment for us, especially on the fact that we were both in new positions, employment-wise. So I think that it was something. Gardening is something we definitely had both enjoyed.
Yeah, we both did it, you know, prior.
Prior.
Yeah.
And we had an opportunity to use this space here that we have. So we took advantage of it, obviously. And I think it did help us. It gave us something to do together, you know, after work or on weekends, so that we could spend time together.
And a challenge to see if we could remember and learn more about how to grow things that, you know, things we never did grow. Turnips I'd never grown before, rutabagas, different vegetables that would be more cold tolerant in the climate of Wisconsin than it would be in other parts of the country. And yeah, it was something to do. It was a fun challenge. It was a fun reward to see what we had been able to work for all year and get something in return and be able to use it during the winter.
I don't think working together, what do you think about us working together?
It's a challenge at times.
It can be, but I think we overall enjoy it.
Right, two people can get a whole lot more done going in the same direction than one person can. So right. It really has worked out well.